See, yes, considering that, you know, a lot of people are still not accepting pets on a, you know, to keep them as house pets, right, or, you know, find it, you know, difficult to look after them. So when I started meeting a lot of people who are pet friendly, and I'm a pet friendly person, I've got my own pet. So when I started meeting few of them who have got pets, then, you know, they had issues in terms of transporting them, because, you know, when they have an issue with, they have to go to the clinic, and if their car is not there, if they come to the office, how do they take the pet to the clinic or, you know, go to the airport? So that's when this triggered off, saying that, you know, okay, why not we look at a service where it will help most of the pet owners to tension-free, you know, kind of a cab services, which, and a pet-friendly driver accompanying the pet, so that, you know, it's a safety precaution also, and they would be happy to send that pet in a pet-friendly cab to a location.
See, we have two different ways. Yeah. Only one is that they can download an app from an Play Store, that is Petcab app. And one more thing is they can just also call the phone and do the online booking. And apart from that, they can log into our website portal also, that is petcab.in, and they can register as a pet parent, and they log in themselves, and where they have been mentioned over there all the fare details, terms and conditions and policies and everything, cost also. Then they can once they register, they can do the online booking through on a website or through an app or through on a phone booking.
We are the first entrance into this logistics section of Petcab, where you know, pet transportation, you could say, locally or relocation within India. So we've got a player in Delhi, a player in Bombay. So yeah, slowly it's picking up. The industry is picking up, and we are doing pretty well, and I'm sure we're going to expand into most of the tier 1 and tier 2 cities soon.
I started my career in 2007 with my first job. I have my mom and dad staying with me, so they're also very, very supportive. So that makes my work a little bit easy. You know, they support. Even now, my first one is here, the second one is with my parents. So of course, that's why I also tell a lot of women or girls, you know, they're not very okay with being in joint families and all that. But being in joint families is a very, very big support, because somebody is there at home to look after your kids. Even now at work, now it's already been 6:30 in the morning, we start here by 7:38. So when there is a parent support at home, whether it could be the taking care of the kids or teaching them, or even the basic, the mental support that comes, is immense.
For us, it's a pet-friendly driver. Without a pet-friendly driver, this is not possible. And for a person to sit in the cab for 12 hours and drive along with a pet, and with the pet owners, or sometimes without the pet owners, and other, you know, pets do dirty the place. They do their poop in the car or the cab, and the drivers have to clean it up. So the biggest asset for us is getting the pet-friendly drivers who have to be trained, mentally challenged to, you know, accept this kind of a role with a lot of heart. They should have a lot of heart, and they should have that passion towards pets. So that is the biggest challenge that we have. We're looking at least 20 cities with Petcab operations in India.